What do we have here? We got the Freeman 451. Man, I love this knife. This is a special episode because I'm saying goodbye to my Freeman. I just happened to be in need of cash, and the special circumstances of this, one of my favorite knives, is this sucker is a big, beefy brute of a knife that every time I pick it up, I want to chop like small trees down with it. I want to jam it into boulders and pry them off so they fall down a mountain onto one of my enemies. You know, something like that. But then again, it costs like $350. So it's like I can't use it for really rough stuff. That bugs me to do. So I've kept it pretty clean, you know, pretty nice. I've you know, carried it a few times, but not very much. I've opened a few packages with it. That's not what it's meant for. It needs to fly and be free to frickin' stab holes through battleships and shit like that. Look at this fucking blade, man. Just a big, thick hunk of frickin' high heat treated Magna Cut. It's just such a great knife, man, but I don't know. I had to free up some money, and so we're saying bye to the Freeman 451. I thought I'd give it one more quick review before whoever picks it up on eBay gets it. How long is this guy? I think the blade is about a 3 point. Let's see. Let's compare it to this crazy Ethan Grow with a long ass blade. I think it's about a 3.7 or 3.8 inch blade, something like that. So it's not a huge, huge blade, but it's just so beefy, man. And it's not some big, deep hollow grind either. So this is full thickness all the way down to where these funky cuts start. Yeah, I'm not sure how they did those exactly. looks like each one was individually milled. I'm not sure. And then look at the edge on that guy. That's like a 15 degree edge. Never touched it. It came just like that with a real high angle edge. Just sharp as shit. It just like, it's one of those dangerously sharp feeling knives. Like if you run your finger this way across it and put any pressure, you're going to need a Band-Aid, like a really good Band-Aid and maybe a stitch or two. Great blade. Great big giant ass button lock button. That just holds it really well. Like there's zero play in this guy. Look at these standoffs, man. Those are some big hinderer size frickin' standoffs. And they do it in the top and the bottom too. Most knives don't do that. Most knives have a couple of standoffs and they are like, okay, like this guy. This guy's a big chunker too, all right? But it only has bolts on the top edge of the knife. It doesn't have any way down here to give it that box-like strength. So, you know, even though this sucker's so big and beefy, I could probably crush it down a little bit. And I can't really tell if I am or not. It's pretty strong. But this guy, it ain't going nowhere, man. It is solid, solid. Now, it's got a little bit of hollowed outness to it, so it's not super heavy. Great balance point, though. Got a nice inlay of this kind of ribbed carbon fiber that kind of matches this ribbing on the other side. Pocket clip is a big beefy chunk of titanium. Sounds great. The pivot is nothing fancy, just a nice solid bolt all the way through with really good bearings. Just drop shutty as hell. Great acoustics on this guy. I'm trying to think. It has excellent thumb opening, excellent reverse flick because they put this little, it's kind of like a bean hole, but you know, it's not all the way through and they left the edges nice and sharp. I mean, it's not sharp like it wants to cut you, but it's sharp enough to catch you. Kind of like a Spyderco thumb hole. It's similar to that edge. So pretty well done, I would say. Reverse flick's great. And of course just buttons them. Oh, and then the flipper tab works excellent too. And listen to the sound, man. Just a great sound. Detent is plenty strong. Just a really, really, I mean, the ergos are great. Even though you look at this giant pocket clip, you'd think that would be poking into your hand maybe or something, but it really doesn't. It's, I don't know, it's just right in the right place. I'm not sure, but it doesn't bother you at all. Maybe because it's rounded a lot. Yeah, I don't know. The grip too, super good. It feels locked in, but not where you couldn't move around a little bit, you know? So it's locked in, but also not locked in, if that makes any sense at all. Probably doesn't. Aircraft aluminum, whatever the hell that means, you know? It's, I think it's actually like a real high-grade aluminum. And then on top of that, they anodized it with this like industrial hard coat. So it's not just regular old, you know, pretty anodized aluminum. It's like industrial hard coat anodized aluminum. What's his name? Jeff, I think, Freeman. I met him at the Blade Show Atlanta, the one before last, not this last one. And that's where I bought this. I bought this directly from him. I think it was like $350, $360, something like that, right off the table. And it was like he only had like one or two left. Or maybe this was the only one left with the carbon fiber that I liked. He had maybe a couple other ones with G10 or something. They have the 451 in titanium too. Man, I would love to have one of those. But that's like freaking another $150 or something above the 350. So 550, 650, whatever the hell. I guess they're getting kind of rare too. He doesn't make a ton of them, and they're, you know, they're kind of popular. So I think people, you know, buy them up. And I think he just kind of makes them in a, you know, a fairly small shop. And so they're not, you know, mass produced by any stretch of the imagination. Obviously, it's MagnaCut, since it says it in freaking gigantic, easy-read letters. So even if you've had, you know, neurological issues, you can still read it. Freeman on the other side in equally big letters. Look at that centering. I've had it for a while, and the centering is still just freaking dead on, man. So solid. Such a great knife. I'm trying to think of a negative. I wish it was cheaper. Then I could beat the shit out of it and I wouldn't feel bad and wouldn't have to sell it. I mean, I don't have to sell it, but it's already up on eBay. If you guys want to go check it out, if you have any interest in a beautiful Freeman. But really, though, I don't know. I can't think of much that's wrong with it. I really got nothing. The pocket clip looks great. You know, aluminum, you know, even though this is good hard coat aluminum, you know, I've used it enough to where I've gotten a little bit of wear on the edges. I don't think it looks that bad. I think it's just like, you know, almost just looks cool. But titanium does wear better than aluminum. So I guess you could say that's sort of a negative for the aluminum version anyway. The titanium one is probably just freaking tough as nails, tough as a freaking CRK or any other, you know, real tough built titanium knife. Kind of reminds me a little bit of, shit, what are they called? Damn it, forget it, doesn't matter. We'll just pretend I didn't say that because I can't remember the name of the knife. And then it won't help the comparison at all. So that's it. We're saying goodbye to my 451, my beautiful, lovely, awesome Freeman 451. Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've had it for, I don't know, a year and a half now, and I will definitely miss it. Goodbye, old friend. I'll miss you. Have a nice day. Planted in my brain, staring night within the sound of silence.